Guys, Mercury retrograde tried to keep me from making this video, but here we are. But maybe I shouldn't jinx it. Hola my beautiful lotus flowers, welcome back or welcome to my channel. If you're into nerding out on everything astrology, spirituality, and self-transformation, this is a community for you. Today we're talking all about the Gemini moon sign, and if you're not completely sure what a moon sign is and this is your first time searching it, please watch this video before you watch this one about the Gemini moon specifically, so that way you understand the moon sign. Otherwise this won't make that much sense to you. But as a little summary, the moon sign basically governs over our deeper emotional nature. It's kind of the sign that people will see in us if they know us deeper on a more intimate level. A lot of people who know you on a surface level in the world won't really get to see that side of you. Some people may never see that side of you. And then your sun sign is more of your egotistical nature, whereas your rising sign is more of how you show up in the world, your physical presence, and the first impression you may give other people. We'll start today's video off by talking about some of the general traits that you should know about a Gemini moon sign to better understand this moon sign. Then we'll talk about some secrets, emotions, and desires that a Gemini moon may have in their lives. And we'll finish off talking about what a Gemini moon needs to feel fulfilled in their life, which is super important, so be sure you're staying tuned for that. First, for the general traits of somebody who has a Gemini moon sign. Before anything else, we need to note that Gemini is the mutable air sign ruled by Mercury, symbolized by the twins. A moon sign ruled by Mercury will make this person an incredibly quick and intelligent thinker who also enjoys communicating these thoughts to others. And if you don't know, Mercury is the planet of communication, thought, and intellect in astrology. So someone with this placement is going to have a very efficient partnership between their instincts and their decisions. For example, oftentimes if this person is in an anxious situation of some sort, they're amazing at quickly thinking of an idea, solution, response, etc. This is because Mercury's influence gives them a special way of not only thinking quickly and creatively — this moon sign can actually be quite creative — but also allows them to excel at observing and analyzing their surroundings, similar to the way Virgo moons tend to, because Virgo is also ruled by Mercury. Adding on to the creative aspect of it, because they are ruled by Mercury and they have such a fast-paced way of thinking and kind of thinking outside of the box, and because this is connected directly to the moon, which is our emotional nature, this does make them quite creative, whether that's in the form of their responses to scary situations or pressured situations or whatever it may be. But it can also be in the way that they communicate. It can make them some type of artist or some type of role that allows them to express the way they think outside of the box creatively. And since Mercury is the planet of communication and intellect, oftentimes this Gemini moon sign is one that absolutely loves to ramble about their passions, because again, we're talking about the moon, which is directly correlated with our deeper needs and emotions and things that we love. So if we are able to ramble to somebody and have a really in-depth conversation with them, the Gemini moon will be so happy, literally so happy. Second, Gemini moons are extremely adaptable to whatever circumstances they're placed in, giving them a powerful inner strength and perseverance that many may not be aware of. As we mentioned, Gemini is the mutable sign, meaning it's a sign that does well with change and can easily adapt to situations. With a Gemini moon specifically, this becomes most true when it comes to situations that may cause emotional shifts within them that could potentially drive others crazy. For example, say they're working in a job that they love for a year and then suddenly they get laid off by this job. Although this may hurt them, of course, they won't dwell on that pain. It may still be there, but their emotions and thoughts move quick enough for them to start figuring out how to move forward, or they'll drop the emotions of it very quickly too. Oftentimes, emotions don't sit too long with them, like they don't let frustration or sadness or any emotion that they feel, especially even if it's a strong one, may not sit with them for long, or they may push it aside or completely let it roll off their back so they can start moving forward. They're very good about this. So this is really what makes them very persistent, and it's not something that I think a lot of people think of when they think of Gemini. This also stems from the fact that their mutability makes them extremely open-minded. So when they're put in a situation that may make a lot of other people just go insane or cause them to go into a deep sadness or whatever it may be, for a Gemini moon, they might actually be able to look at it as a good thing or be able to think like, oh, well, now I can try this or I'll try that. They're very good at being open-minded to different ways of living their life, different ways of finding happiness, success. They're not really somebody who is gonna become so stagnant in where they are or so fixated on where they are like a fixed sign might, such as like a Taurus or a Scorpio. Those signs might be really, really upset when they're thrown out of a situation that they were used to or they relied on or they enjoyed, and they make it too attached to it. So when it's taken away from them, it could be super, super hard on them. But with a Gemini moon, oftentimes it's hard for them to really fully commit to things anyways. So the moment that they lose something or something gets taken away from them, they're very quick to being open to move on to something else and something new. Third, they will spend a lot of time thinking about their deeper emotions rather than openly acting on them or actually feeling them. Because this is an air moon sign, this person will always take a more logical approach to their emotions, aiming to understand them by thinking about them and analyzing them in order to gain a better understanding of them. With Gemini moon specifically, this person has a super fast, turbulent thinking process, like we mentioned earlier. So they'll probably have a difficult time figuring out how they truly feel about something or why they're feeling a certain way, often thinking themselves into a black hole of possibilities that never ends. The best way that this moon sign might actually better understand their emotions is if they've been able to communicate them or vent them in some way, since communication is key for this moon sign. So whether that's in the form of actually speaking to somebody or writing it out or whatever it may be. Fourth, Gemini moons thrive in environments/relationships where they feel that they're understood, open communication is present, and they're able to express their witty, humorous, childlike side. Geminis are represented by the twins to symbolize Gemini's extreme duality in every area of life. Two sides of many Geminis that are well known is their ability to be intelligent, yet simultaneously have a childlike sense of humor and nature about them. With Gemini moons, we've already discussed that they actually tend to be extremely emotionally and mentally strong, having great composure over their emotions because they're able to think through things instead of recklessly acting on their emotions. But it's because of this restless, really intense emotional, mental process that they constantly have going on that they really do need to have open communication present. They need to be able to feel like they can talk about anything or let the thoughts that they get jumbled in their head, let them go without judgment. But at the same time, while having open communication, they usually want things to stay more lighthearted. Again, that's that childlike energy that they have. And remember, I said childlike, not childish. But it's this childlike, youthful energy that they have. They like to keep things more lighthearted. A lot of times they might make jokes of their emotions or something, especially if they're openly communicating it to somebody. Being in an environment that's way too heavy or way too intense can be really uncomfortable for them, especially if they're like around a lot of people that are like just very sad or very negative. The Gemini moon can really feel super awkward and probably acts the most awkward in this environment as well. Not only that, but it can also make them feel like they might get judged for showing, you know, their humorous, kind of lighthearted side or the thoughts that they have that they want to express. So going back to the twins, Gemini moons just love to be able to display their more mature, complex mental process, but also be able to keep things more lighthearted and more fun, if that makes sense. If you're a Gemini moon watching this, be sure you leave a comment down below. And if you're not Gemini moon, be sure you still leave your moon sign because I love to know who's watching. And do not forget, please, if you like this video, to give it an actual like. It only takes 1 second and I don't even know who liked it. So it's anonymous. So you should do it because it helps me so much. And hit the subscribe button and the bell if you don't want to miss future videos like this one. I'm so grateful to you for being here. Thank you so, so much. If you hit the like, subscribe, and the bell. Now, for secrets, emotions, and desires that a Gemini moon may have in their life. Number one, Oftentimes, Gemini moons require a certain level of independence, lightheartedness, and freedom in their lives, or else they quickly become unhappy or bored. Majority of the time, this trait is going to showcase itself the most in a Gemini moon's intimate relationships. One, because we're talking about the moon sign, and that's where these traits are going to be more present in general, is in their close relationships. But two, because this is also where Gemini moon's like independence and freedom becomes the most challenged. If they have a partner that's just way too needy, clingy, emotional, possessive, then it's one of the number one ways to completely frustrate a Gemini moon sign. Not only will it frustrate them, but in addition to that, if they feel like they're caged in and they can't do anything without their partner watching them or questioning them, then they're going to start feeling very bored and frustrated. Gemini moons just love to be outside of the house, experiencing new things, trying new things, doing different things, talking about different things, meeting different people. And if they feel that somebody in their close life is hindering that, then they are not going to be happy. Second, although this is a quick moving moon sign, they can actually suffer from stagnancy in their lives more than people would expect. Now, I know people wouldn't usually pair any Gemini placements with the word stagnant. That doesn't seem right, right? When we think of stagnant, we think of the fixed signs. But hear me out. In the case of a Gemini moon specifically, they are one of the most open-minded, creative, complex thinkers in the zodiac by far. If you have this moon sign, then you can compete for most complex thinker, 100%. And this can sometimes be to a Gemini moon's detriment. What happens is that they can literally see any angle, any perspective, anything that somebody throws at them, they can literally understand, comprehend it. They just have such an open mind and it thinks so complex that they, even if they're not being thrown a perspective from somebody else, inside their own mind, they're making up a bunch of different angles. Like, for example, say you see two people interact and they start arguing over something. I don't know what, but they start arguing. And person A, see, you know, to somebody else, to the other people around the Gemini moon who are watching the situation, they probably have decided. They're like, oh, person A was in the right. Well, yeah, it's all person B's fault. And then there's other people that are watching that are on person B's side. But the Gemini moon is 100% guaranteed to be the person standing there watching that situation, thinking,
I mean, person A was wrong for that, but like person B was also in the wrong here. But see, I understand why person A would feel that way. And person B, oh man, but who knows, they might have been having a bad day.
And then before you know it, they have a million possibilities of perspectives between those two people going on in their brain. And they literally will take a neutral position and they won't decide whether person A or person B is in the wrong. When it comes to life in general, this can cause stagnancy because instead of deciding on something because they see a million possibilities, a million outcomes, but instead of deciding on how to move forward despite all the possible paths and all the possible outcomes, they might end up actually staying neutral, like staying their ground, because there's so many possibilities, they don't know which path to go in and they get stuck. And this is an extremely important thing to point out about Gemini moons, especially if you're a Gemini moon watching this, because again, it's not something that people expect. And I think it doesn't really get talked about, but it's very, very common and very important. Third, Gemini moon's extraordinarily fast-paced mind may channel itself as physical reactions in the body, such as headaches, anxiety, etc. Now, before this, I mentioned how this moon sign may think themselves into complete oblivion and become stagnant because of it. But not only will this take a mental toll on them and cause them to potentially become stagnant in life, this can take a really big toll on them physically. Like I said, they can think themselves into so many different possibilities. And another thing that can happen is there's a big possibility that Gemini moons suffer from some type of anxiety or, you know, panic attacks, which go hand in hand with anxiety, things like this, because of the things that they think about. They will be able to imagine so many possibilities in life. They can imagine so many things that maybe a lot of people aren't thinking of. You know that term, ignorance is bliss. A lot of Gemini moons will not really be ignorant or have that bliss that comes with ignorance, because whether they like it or not, they can think of so many reasons to be anxious. They can literally think, oh my gosh, but if I spend money on that, then what if I don't have money next week? And then before I know it, that means that my car is going to get repossessed. And before I know it, that means I'm not going to be able to pay my phone bill. I'm not going to have a phone. And they just like spiral into this domino effect of events that haven't happened and potentially think themselves into a physical stress ball and suffer from extreme headaches, migraines, anxiety, panic attacks, etc. Just things that are not good for them in their physical health. And if you're a Gemini moon and you've noticed patterns in your physical health, start really paying attention to where your mind goes when you're not really paying attention to it. Because a lot of times our mind is constantly talking, especially for Gemini moons. And listen to what it's talking about, because it may be feeding you a lot of dissatisfying information that's not doing you good for your actual physical health. Lastly, let's talk about what a Gemini moon may need in life to feel fulfilled. First, because of their need for freedom and fun that we mentioned before, they become anxious, restless, and gloomy if they've been stuck in one place for too long. Gemini moons require quite a bit of constant mental stimulation, excitement, and everything to feel the most energized and fulfilled. And if they're not having experiences that provide that to them, then they're going to feel like their battery is getting drained extremely fast. Like if they have to be in an office job with no windows, or they've been stuck inside their house for days because of bad weather, whatever the situation may be, they just have an innate desire to go out and see the world and do things and see things, because by being outside of a usual environment, they get to intake all of this information constantly. And that's what Gemini moon's brain loves to do. It loves seeing new things and getting new information and trying new things. I did mention, you know, for Gemini moons watching this, that it is important that you're able to give yourself some variation in your life. If you notice that you just feel so drained and bored and stuck and depressed and whatever it is that you're feeling, know that you do need mental stimulation of some sort. Do something to get your mind engaged. Play some video games, go outside, go shopping, go places where you can see, try, and just get your senses stimulated and get your mind moving, because that's what it needs. But on the other end, don't overcrave stimulation also, because Gemini moons can overcrave stimulation, which is also unhealthy. Because it can, again, feed into anxiety, feed into sadness, because you just want to do so much that you end up feeling like you don't get to do anything or something. So also remembering to be present and grateful is very important for Gemini moons, because sometimes slowing down is needed for everybody. Second, Gemini moons need a channel in their lives where there is non-judgmental, clear, and open communication present. This placement loves to explore new possibilities, new potential ways of life, new ways of living, new foods, new clothes, whatever it may be. They just love trying things, and they love having people around them that allow them to live their eccentric lifestyle. So having an environment where they feel they can fully express this open-mindedness, this open way of life that they like to live, is really, really important to them. And if for some reason you're a Gemini moon that's not in an environment where you have this comfortability to express yourself, or you feel like you can't, I highly recommend taking up some way of communicating your frustrations and getting them out of your head, especially journaling, something like journaling or maybe drawing to get those emotions out, to get that frustration out, is a really good way. For Gemini moons, transmuting their emotions into some type of communication can be a very freeing way of living their lives, so they feel more fulfilled. Third, it's highly beneficial for them to create some sort of structure in their lives in order to not only be more organized, but to maintain better mental clarity as well. Because the mind and emotions of this placement can be so hectic and chaotic and all over the place, this can show up in their physical life as well. Whether that means they're disorganized, messy, they just can't seem to get anything done no matter how hard they try, etc. Although it's not exactly natural for a lot of Gemini moons to be super organized, unless you know you have other aspects and placements that are helping you with this. But if you're one of those Gemini moons that has a hard time with it, it will do you good to take time to try and become a little bit more organized. And you know, it is also important for you to feel happy that you do feel that there is freedom in your schedule. So don't overwhelm yourself. Just give yourself light structure, something light to stick to, because it will make a huge difference, especially because a lot of Gemini moons, you know, they want to do this and that, but then they end up doing nothing because they don't get anything done, or they don't complete anything, or they don't have the time because of the disorganization and the chaotic mental thinking and all the thoughts going through their mind. It's just chaos. So just taking time, setting time aside to figure out some type of structure that works for you in your daily life. If you notice that you struggle with this, then I highly, highly, highly recommend it. Again, if you're a Gemini moon, be sure you leave a comment down below or leave your moon sign down below. And don't forget that if you enjoyed this video, I really appreciate if you hit the like button, the subscribe and bell for me. And if you want more, you can head over to the LaBlue Lotus Facebook community, where we talk more about using astrology and spirituality for self-transformation. For even more content, you can head to my Instagram at Marisa LaBlue, and you can watch these videos if you haven't already, because they will help you so much more on your journey. But until I see you in the next video, I am so, so grateful to have you here. Thank you so much. But until next time, adios.